राम रघुवर को हे तु कृसानु भानु हेम कर को
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
विधि हरि हर मय वेद प्राण सो
श्री राम जय
अगुण अनुपम गुण निधान सो
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
महामंत्र जोई जपत महेशु गणराओ
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
प्रथम पूजियत नाम प्रभा अमीको
श्री राम जय जय राम
राम एकता बसतियतारी सिदसहु
श्री राम जय जय राम
बिनु पद चलै सो नै बिनु काना
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
असि सब भांति अलौकिक करनी। रामचंद्र की जय। जय 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 मन मो जय 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 मधुसूदना। Wonderful stuti written on the sweetness of Bhagwan Shri Krishna. He says, Atharam Maturam Vadanam Maturam Nayanam Maturam Hasitam Maturam Maturadhipate Akhilam Maturam. And Bhagwan's face is sweet, his lips are sweet, his eyes are sweet, his, Everything about Bhagwan is sweet. If you meditate on Bhagwan long enough, you will also get diabetes. But there is a good kind of diabetes. This other type of diabetes will kill we. This meditation on Bhagwan and you get that type of diabetes, you get mukti. Mukti or moksha. The chorus is just four names of Bhagwan. If you remember those four names, you can also chant the chorus. Govinda Hare, Gopal Hare, Nandalal Hare, Shri Krishna Hare. They're very simple. Govinda Hare, Gopal Hare, Nandalal Hare, Shri Krishna Hare.
Govinda Hare, Gopal Hare, Nandalal Hare, Shri Krishna Hare.
Adharam Madhuram Vadanam Madhuram Nayanam Madhuram Asitam Madhuram.
Govinda Hare, Gopal Hare, Nandalal Hare, Shri Krishna Hare.
Hridayam Madhuram Gamanam Madhuram Madhuram Vachanam Madhuram Charitam Madhuram Vasanam Madhuram Valitam Madhuram 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 जो सुमिरत सिद्धि होई गणनायक करि बर बदन करउ अनुग्रह सोई निरासि शुभ गुण सदन मोक होई
If you are joining us tonight for this first time, we are seeing this Ramcharitamanas of Goswami Tulsidas ji, and specifically the Shiva Parvati Samvad of the Balkand, which is the first kanda of the Ramcharitamanas. I told you on one of the previous days, we call it Tulsi Ramayana, but the correct name is Ramcharita Manas. Try to get the right name. Ramayana is written by Valmiki ji in Sanskrit. And from that, Tulsidas ji, not only that, there's another one written by Ved Vyas ji. It's called as Adhyatma Ramayana. There's one in South India which is written by the great poet in Tamil, the great poet called as Kamba. Kamban Ramayana is called. And Ramayana is written in several languages across India. But I think the most famous of them has become this Tulsi Ramayana. Millions everywhere because of its easy chanting, ragas and music and all of that. It has more than one alambana rather than just the memory of it. You could sing it and all that. So it has survived. It has become more popular than the others. And in this Tulsidas ji says, he has packed all of our shastras into it. He himself says in the beginning. All the other Vedas, Upanishad, everything, Bhagavatam, Puranas, he has packed everything. Nana Purana Nigama Gama Sammatam Yat Ramayane Nigaditam, Tulsidas ji says. In this Ramayana I put everything. So you want complete scripture by itself. You want to study scripture, just study Ramayana in all its detail. Amazing scripture it is. And in this Ramcharitmanas, seven khandas are there, the Bal Khanda and the Ayodhya Khanda, long khandas. Half the Ramayana finish in two khandas. Half. The next five khandas is the next half. So the Bal Khanda, Ayodhya Khanda, the two first, is the longest, really long. Both of them cross 300 dohas. The rest of them, among the rest of them, the longest will be Uttar Khanda, which cross only 100. So how long these two? And in this Bal Khanda of this Ramcharitmanas, there are so many stories, because the introduction to Ramcharitmanas. And one of the most important stories is the Shiva Parvati Samvad and the Shiva Parvati Vivah, the wedding of Shiva and Shiva Parvati in the Vivah. And Indian people like wedding too bad, you know. Because of this thing. Because everywhere in our scripture there's Ram Vivaha, Shiva Vivaha, everywhere Vivaha only, isn't it? Married. Nice here. An Indian wedding has gone for 3 days. So these young people and all that get a little fed up with this thing now. 3 days, boy? Good. Well, somebody come by me last week. Real thing, eh? Swamiji, you don't know any pandit who could do that wedding now for now? They feel 3 days, boy. But anyway, it is all symbolic rituals and it is good for the soul. So we should adhere to it. It's very good. 3 days better. In 3 days, at least you have some time to make up your mind, isn't it? Yeah. If it's 1 day, you have no time, you get yourself into... Anyway, everything has some benefit in it, you have to see. 3 days, good. So now the Shiva Parvati Samvad ends with the Shiva Parvati Vivaha, the marriage of Shiva and Parvati. But it starts in a previous life of Parvati, which is called as Sati, and we have been seeing that all week, all of you who have been here. Sati had deceived the Lord Shiva and had also disrespected Rama by taking the form of his wife and coming in front of him also. So those are big things, you know. In society and all, respect and all in families, they're a very, very important thing. And you see, we lose our honor. In many parts of the world today, there is something called honor killing. Families don't like to lose their honor. Honor is a big thing. So, Parvati ji, Sati ji, was relinquished by Bhagwan Shivaji, and he said, I'm not going to touch this Sati again as long as she is in this body. And Bhagwan made it, and she prayed to Bhagwan Ram, and Bhagwan made it in such a way that it came to pass that she had to drop that body. And now she was born in the house of Himavan, the Himalayan kingdom. And her father was Himavan, and her mother was Maina. And when she was a little girl, Narad came there, and he read that palm, you know. And he said, this little girl will be the apple of the eye of the whole world. She is Jagat Amba, the mother of the... Knowing that, and she will be worshipped by the whole world, and she will be lucky, and she brought so much of prosperity and growth to that Himalayan kingdom and all that. But she will marry a fellow who is homeless and penniless, vagrant, vagabond, loiterer. Loiters everywhere and all that. And the parents were very much distressed by that. And they told Narad, you do something. Narad said, well, the thing which can be done is, let her do tapas and she'll marry Lord Shiva. He has all of these gunas also. But these gunas in a great person will be positive. These gunas are homeless in a person who is not great. Homelessness in a person who is not great, that is a durguna. But homelessness in case of Lord Shiva, that is a great guna, great quality, because he's seen as the very embodiment of dispassion, detachment, which is the things taught in the Shastra. A vagrant who is homeless, anybody say he have dispassion? Vairagya and all? Nobody will say, isn't it? So, Narad gave this solution. Let her do tapas to marry Lord Shiva. And we saw last night, now she went and did core tapas more than 4,000 years. And 4,000 years in those days was, this is Treta Yuga. Ek bar Treta Yuga, Treta Yuga Mahi. Gaye Sambhu Kumbhaja Rishi Pahi. That's how the whole katha started. Treta Yuga only. So now, she did this tapas and she heard this Akashvani. Akashvani means this. The voice from the space. And Brahmaji was talking. Brahmaji is the one who is responsible for manifesting this whole world. He spoke in that voice. And he said, okay, Bhavani, you give up all this tapas. Core tapas, your body has become emaciated now, skin and bone only. Now, you will certainly marry Lord Shiva. But you know, everything that, you see, boons and all, right? When boons are granted, you have to be careful. Eh? Anything like that, when the advertisement does look nice. Eh? But when you get a real thing, like when we were doing the raffle for the school, we win a brand new Toyota Corolla. So it's not that when you win the car, you come in the ashram, we give you a key, and you can go home. That is so easy, isn't it? You have to now take that car and go and do register your name, get insurance, and first of all, that car was in Toyota company. You have to go there. We have to write them. Say, dear, this is the person who win. Otherwise, anybody could go there and say, I win. It's a long process before you could go home with your car. So it's not so easy. Everything has looked nice only. You win a brand new car. That's the line. So you know, Brahmaji said, yes, you will marry Lord Shiva. But it's not so easy. Now Tulsidasji gives this whole story. Now this is a very long, I'll have to jump at those who brought their Ramayana and all, I'll tell you where we're going on. Because we can't finish this in 9 days. It's a long story. Long, long, long. Now I'll tell you all in between what happened before the wedding. Not Matiko ranting, eh? Not Matikor and all that kind of Matikor. Once when I was in high school, I carry in school some kurma. Kurma, you know? So I had a teacher, a very nice fellow, African fellow. So I give him a paka kurma. Because he had some celebration home. So when I give him now, I don't know if he knows where is that. I say, sir, you know where is this? When I give him the paka kurma. He said, what? How I won't know is this? Every Friday when I go mati kurma, I eating this thing too bad. You mix up some words there, you see. Anyway, so I will tell now what happened before that marriage. A lot of things happened. I don't know how much I will be able to cover inside of there, but now see this. She heard the voice of Brahmaji saying, yes, you will marry Lord Shiva. Tulsidas says, okay, now let me tell you what happened. When Sati had given up her body in the Sabha of Daksha Prajapati, her father's place, and Bhagwan sent that Veerabhadra, Veerabhadra went there and destroyed everything and beat out all them gods and everybody. Then, from that time, Lord Shiva, now no Sati is there in Kailash, he's alone. So he started roaming the earth everywhere. For thousands of years he roamed. And they would stop him here and they'll tell him, tell Ram Katha. So he'll tell Ram Katha. Again, he'll go somewhere, they'll stop him there and he'll tell, tell Ram Katha. And like that, he went from place to place. Now, on during his travels, Bhagwan Sri Ram met him. Bhagwan Sri Ram came to Lord Shiva and he told something. See now, this is number 76. You'll have to jump to number 76, I think. Bhagwan Sri Ram made a request of Lord Shiva.
अब बिनती मम सुनहु सेवा जौ मो पर निजने हो राम जौ मो पर निजने जाई विवाहु नहीं या मोही मांगे देउ सिया पर राम चंद्र की जय शरणम पवन सुत हनु
tell you that Lord Shiva in our Shastras is called as Paramavairagi. Paramavairagi means who is totally detached from everything in this world. Not attached to anything. And his Shastras tell the one who can become a Vairagi, he will soon reach God. Because we are attached to this thing, to this world, that's why we don't reach anywhere. Attachment means all of us, I can't do without this, I can't do without that. Actually, the human being only need food, clothing, and shelter, you know. Roti, kapra, and makan. He only needs food, clothing, and shelter. But we come in this world, and we get attached to this thing, that thing, the other thing. And every day, our attachment, instead of getting less, get more and more. Eh? See, in the old days, I'll show you how. More and more. Eh? Look here. You can't do without this, can't do without that. In the old days, when you come to a yagna like this, I remember, Vijay will tell you also, when you go to any satsang or yagna in the village here, you have to sit down on a pal, correct or not? Huh? Well, all them pal days gone. Right? Then after the pal, they started to make wooden benches. I'll give you the sequence. Eh? They started to make wooden benches. Then when you go, you sit down on a wooden bench. Then the wooden bench thing went away. Then they started to make wooden chairs. The type of clack, 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 clack. When they finish in the end, they have to make so much a noise with that thing. You remember that? That wooden chair that had to fold. And stacking that thing was such a terrible problem. Then not only that, when you do yagna, like bluebirds have yagna once a year, right? You do yagna this year and you put on that chair. When you come next year, we will eat all the foot and thing. When you go to termite. Termite, you don't have the chair when you sit down. Right? Not we will, termite. So now they get rid of that wooden chair. Then they started bringing iron chair. They used to stack that iron chair, right? Heavy everything, isn't it? No, that iron chair too much to move around, too heavy, this, that, cumbersome work. Now you see they bring? The plastic chair, see? And beside that, that iron chair had no handrest. When they make the plastic, now you have handrest, they see what? So we getting attached from one thing to the next. And every time the comfort have to increase, correct? So we can't do without comforts. So instead of getting less attached in this world, we get more attached. And therefore, we are moving further and further away from God. That's no joke, eh? The more attached to this world, further away from God. The less attached to this world, closer to God. That is the equation. An inverse relationship. So, Lord Shiva is the very exemplar of detachment. And so, now, Bhagwan Ram approaches this Lord Shiva, who, knowing that Sati is not there, nobody, I am alone, he roaming all over the world, telling Ram Katha, this, that. Right? Now Rama approaches. Ava binati mama sunahu Shiva. Oh, my dear Shiva, you please listen to my request. I have something to ask you. This is my request from you. Jau mo para nija nehu, if you love me, and which Lord Shiva did. He tells, Rama says, if you love me, jai, you go, bibahahu, sailajahi, yaha muhi mage dehu. You go and marry Parvati. This is my request. Rama asked. So now, Lord Shiva, Param Vairagi, you know, he want nothing. See, if he want no clothes, he want no house, he want no jewel, no money, no nothing, why go, why for? Isn't it? So now see Lord Shiva's reply, the most wonderful reply in Ramayana. You'll never see this thing anywhere again. See this thing. Lord Shiva replying now.
Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Shiva jadapi ho chit asnani nath bachan puni meethi na jahi
Shri
Ram Jai Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Sir thari aayasu kariya tumara param dharamo yaha
Shiva. Now to Shiva's reply. Kahashiva means Shiva said. He replied to Rama. Rama's request, you go and marry Parvati. Them two of them have to be real close, you know. Isn't it? You ever hear anybody tell anybody that? They have to be real close, na?
Kahashiva jadapi uchita asa nahi.
First reply, I don't think that is a good idea. See Lord Shiva's reply, I don't think that is a good idea. Eh? Because I see, I am totally detached from, not from me, That not good for she. Yeah, correct or not? Which wife would want a husband who totally detached from she? He had paying no attention to she. In the morning when he get up, he going to him to look to see if she there. Which wife could want a husband like that? Huh? And see, I tell you, when I travel in everywhere, I stay with families, you know. And the families, they teach me everything. I don't know everything about going on. All little detail, you know. One fella tell me, he did a real story. Eh? This man is a professor in a university. He tell me, what happened? He married, he's Indian, from India. He married an American wife. Huh? So now Indian etiquette and Indian behavior and the way they treat their wife and that different from Americans that treat their wife. Isn't it? That different thing. So he telling me one day, a real story. He said he dropped his wife by the hairdresser. She said, drop me by the hairdresser. Beauty salon. So she gone. He dropped. She there after 2-3 hours, he picked she up. When picked she up, did he drive home? He said, but she said, but you are telling me nothing about my hair. Hare Rama. Goodness. He said, what do you mean? She said, well, this is America, you know. If you drop your wife by the hairdresser and when they pick you up, you're supposed to say, darling, your hair looks beautiful, you know. This is America. It is not India. Eh? He said, sorry, darling. Your hair looks beautiful. She's teaching him American etiquette. You see? So he said, he learned. He had to learn. What are you going to do? You think I just hear simple, unamusing story? My eyes here, not the best story. You already hear no story like me. So he said, after some time, 2-3 months pass again, I request you carry me by the beauty salon. So he carry she again. So she go on this day, spend she time and all, he come pick she up. So this time he done learn, right? This time when she come in the car, he said, darling, your hair looks beautiful. She said, I didn't do my hair, I do my nails. Yeah, I see. Real thing, eh? No, makeup story. Makeup, yeah. So, the husband and wife relationship have all of these things, isn't it? Now, she married, this is Parvati will marry and come in my place. And besides, me, I have no place self. She will suffer. Isn't it? What place? Where go bring she? Kailash has nothing. You don't hear ice. So he say, I don't think there's a good idea. Lord Shiva's first response. The second reason for making that type of response is that he's a detached person, you know. Detachment, he doesn't have anything. Why he wants something more? A detached person is one who, the more they get, the more they detach. And a touch person, the more they get, the more they want. But he says a nice thing. He says, Nath, bachan puni meti na jahi. But your request, because it is made by Ram, because it is made by you, you know. Even though I don't think it's a good idea. But because you made the request. You see the greatness of, it is true also. The world works like that. And if you your neighbor come and tell you, give me one of the hibiscus plant you have in your yard, Dana. And then you and your neighbor don't pull up already. No man, how about the government plant and give you? But if your guru come, And he said, hey, give me that plant where you have there. Very good. You see? There's a difference. There's a difference in who asks him. Who asks? You see? So Lord Shiva told, since you ask now, what are you at? You tell me, Siddhari Ayasu Kariya Tumhara. I take your words on my head and I will fulfill it. Because you told me to go and marry Parvati. Paramadharamu Yaha Nata Hamara. This is my duty now, supreme duty, to fulfill your words. And Lord Shiva tells the principle, Matu Pita Gura. Prabhu ke bani binahi vichar kariya subha jani. Means without thinking, if we follow the words of matu, mother, pita, father, guru, or teacher, prabhu, or master, if we follow the words of these four without thinking, he says it cannot but be that thing will end up being good. It may appear bad in the short run, but in the long run it will certainly be good. This is the principle. Tuma sabhavanti paramahita kari agya sira par nath tumhari. I take your words and I will fulfill it. Now, Lord Shiva called Saptarishis. Now I have to tell you the story. I can't chant now because we will not have enough time. Lord Shiva called the Saptarishis and he told them, go there and test that Parvati. See if she really wants to marry me, you know. You give her some test. So Saptarishis went. Parvati was still there. Brahmaji had just told, leave this tapas, now you will marry Lord Shiva. Saptarishis reached there. Saptarishis, seven rishis are there. Saptarishis is seven rishis. Atri, Rishi, and Jamadagni, and Vishwamitra, Vasishta, Ityadi, there are seven rishis, Gautama Rishi and all. So, seven of them are there in a group also. He called them. Called them means what? Lord Shiva only meditated and all of them reached there. Then, go there and test that Parvati. And after testing her, see she really wants to marry me or not. Then you tell, since Rama told already, she might want to, you know. You go and tell her father to go and bring her home and this and that. He gave instructions. Saptarishis went there. They saw Parvati. She's skin and bone only. They asked, why are you doing this to all these tapas? What do you want? What are you trying to get? She said, I'm feeling shy to tell you. She wants to marry Lord Shiva. But in the end, she tells. What? You want to marry Lord Shiva? Who tell you to do that? She said, Narad. They say, but something wrong with you. First of all, you listen to that Narad. Who does listen to Narad? He only set fire all over anywhere he go. Who does listen to Narad? You listen to he. Then second thing, look what he tell you now. He tell you to go and marry this Lord Shiva. You want to marry such a person? He had no house, he had no nothing. He's all about running from place to place. He wouldn't even look at you after marrying me. He go ask, who is you? After marrying, you know, like that they went on. First they talk all bad things about Narad. Then they talk all bad things about Lord Shiva. Then in the end, after a whole long discourse, all many pages is there. After all that, no. She said, all you say, all you want. I want to marry Lord Shiva. It's going to be the end of it, the whole thing. So they were also very happy because they came there to test only. And they came back and told Lord Shiva, she's adamant. Lord Shiva is also very happy now, knowing that, you know, she's not forced to do something and this and that, all that kind of thing. So they went and they told also to Himavan, her father. And they revealed that she Jagat Janani Ambika. Devi herself, she's born in your house. You go now and bring her, and everything is set. Lord Shiva will marry her, right? So Lord Shiva, when they told him that yes, she's happy to marry you, she wants to marry you and nobody else, Lord Shiva, and he gone into dhyan now. get into absorption. No, he know nothing about going on outside. I know when he go another 87,000, 100,000 years go past right there. So now all the devatas saw that. At that time, the devatas were having a problem. There was one fellow by the name of Tarakasur, a great big demon. That fellow didn't know any death, he didn't know any old age, no disease, no nothing. And he was every day growing stronger and stronger. He beat out all the devatas, run them out from Swarga, all about them. They take cover in caves here, they're all about Tarakasur. They didn't know how to get rid of the Tarakasur. So they went to Brahmaji. Brahmaji said, well, I will tell you, the only way this Tarakasur will die is if Lord Shiva has a son. That means we have to expedite this marriage. Any son born from Lord Shiva, he will be only able to kill that Tarakasur. So we have to expedite this marriage. But I seen from here, Lord Shiva, now he gone into? Yeah. He knows nothing about going on outside. So the devata say, no problem, man. We go fix that. They send Kamadev now. They summon, Indra summon Kamadev. Kamadev is the lord of love. The lord of passion. He's Cupid. Cupid, you know, in English. And Cupid, not stupid. Cupid, real smart. Kamadev, the lord of lust and love and love and what is that? The erotic sentiment. He's Kama, he's the lord of that. So they call Kamadev now. And they say, you go there. Kamadev said, what? I tell you, I'm not stupid. Because if I go there and disturb Lord Shiva's dhyan, his meditation, right? And he opens his eyes. He opens his third eye. Mm-hmm. Finish. He'll turn me to ashes. So Indra and Agni and Vayu and Ityadi and Kubir and all of them, they said, but look here. You know, working for the benefit of the others is the highest dharma in the world. Kamadev said, I truth. Working for the benefit of others. And you know, Kamadev went there to disturb Lord Shiva's dhyan, knowing fully well that Lord Shiva will open his eye and burn him to ashes. But he's doing it for the benefit of others. You know, in this Ramayana, that is a recurring and deep theme in this Ramayana. Jatayu gave his life to save Sita. Means, at that time, this principle is introduced in Ramayana, that working for the benefit of others, if we die in working for the benefit of others, we'll go straight to Bhagwan. Jatayu died doing service to Bhagwan. Hanumanji spent his whole life doing service to Bhagwan and the whole world. Shabari became Shabari because she was doing service to that Rishi. Every great soul you will see in this Ramayana is because they are doing selfless service for somebody else. So, this principle is there. And when Kamadev recalled this principle, he said, okay, I'll go. And he went there to destroy the dhyan, the meditation of Lord Shiva. The description is an elaborate one. Kamadev brought every atom in the universe under his control. Everywhere, things started being attracted to each other. Things which are contrary. The power and the force of Kamadev's influence made, you see, because he's the erotic sentiment, the calm, desire, lust. Everything started becoming attracted to each other in this world. And somewhere in between there, Kamadev disturbed the dhyana of Lord Shiva. And he opened his third eye and he burned that Kamadev to ashes. He realized this Kamadev who caused this, and he was hiding in a tree right there. He took his arrow, that fatal arrow. It is symbolized by the projection of an immense and powerful bout of desire. And when he struck Lord Shiva, he came out of his dhyan and realized it is the work of Kamdev. That is a whole katha all by itself. That portion has to be taken all by itself in a whole yajna like that. So nice it is. Anyway, now I want to get to the wedding, so I have to... Yeah. And today we don't see Matiko running going on in the road when we come in here. So now, when he burnt, then Kamdev, his wife came, the Rati. Rati Devi, how you burnt my husband? What is this? She pleaded and all. Bhagwan said, don't worry. Is that she gave a boon. That in the next yuga, when Bhagwan Shri Krishna is born there, when the Lord takes avatar as Lord Krishna, your husband, Kamdev, will be born there and he'll be close to Lord Krishna also. So long story is there also. So like that, boon was given to Rati. And now, Lord Shiva's dhyan is woken up, come out. So Lord Shiva, Lord Brahmaji said, now let us tell him, let us get this marriage going. You have to marry this Parvati because the devatas are having this trouble with this Tarakasur. Then you already promised Rama that you will marry Parvati. And then Parvati, so how many reasons? One is the actions of the Lord have multi-dimensional phala. The results of one action of the Lord has a ripple effect into many sectors and fields in different places. When we do one action, that action will only affect one thing. But when Bhagwan does an action that has... So now this one thing, what he'll fulfill by marrying Parvati alone, one act. By marrying Parvati alone, he'll give credence to Brahmaji. Because Brahmaji came with all the gods to ask him to marry Parvati. He gave credence to Brahmaji's and Brahmaji's words and requests. Then Rama also he promised already. So he'll fulfill his words to Rama. Then he'll fulfill the result of Parvati's tapas. Because the devotee does tapas. If, when Rama took avatar also, same thing. Number of things simultaneously in one stroke. In one stroke, fulfilled so many things. So now he'll fulfill grant the karma phala to Parvati for having done all that tapas there also. Then all the gods are being tormented by this Tarakasur. So when Lord Shiva gets married, he'll get a son and rid the gods of all of their problems. Like that. So in this way, then the great Himavan also will get glory because his daughter is married to Lord Shiva. So he said, my daughter is married to Lord Shiva. He will also get glory. He will also get praise because of that. So many things in one stroke. But anyway, now, this is the long, and all of them in one katha by themselves. If you see there, the burning of Kamdev, there's a whole katha by itself. Then the devatas going to Brahmaji and doing supplication there, and Brahmaji and all that, the whole other. Now, Brahmaji came with all the gods and told Prabhu, you now have to fulfill your words to Rama. And so you please start getting ready for this marriage. Now this you have to jump to 91. Typical Hindu wedding, right? You have to dress up the wedding car and all the typical things. No. All the gods were invited. Brahmaji, everybody there, no. Date and time for leaving and everything fixed by all the rishis and this, all everybody. Brahmaji, Vishnu, all of them going to follow this one. All of them not decorate all the UFOs, means all their aerial chariots, yes, Pushpak Viman that they call. So decorate all the Pushpak Viman and all that kind of thing. And then here, going on the road now, they made so many different types of Vahan. Tulsi Rashi described. Vahan means vehicles. And they started decorating. Tulsi Rashi described this whole thing.
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai Ram.
गगन करहि सिंगारा जटा हो पुट अहि मोरु सवारा
जय राम जय जय राम जय राम
कुंडल कंचन पैरे प्याला तनु विभूति पथ के हरि छाला ललात सुंदर सिर गंगा नयन तीन उपवीत भुजंगा गरल कंत उर नर सिर माला अशिव वेश शिव धाम कृपाला त्रिशूल अरुदमरु बिराजा चले बस जही बाजा देखि सेवई सुर त्रिय मुसुकाई वर लायक दुलैनी जगनाई बिरंची आदि सुर प्राता चरि चरि वाहन चले पराता श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
शिव शंभुगण लगे सवारन सकल सुर वाहन विविध विमान दे ऑल स्टार्टेड डेकोरेटिंग ऑल देयर व्हीकल्स एंड ऑल द चैरियट्स एंड दिस एंड दैट नाउ वी गोइंग टू बी मेकिंग बारात नाउ बारात हैव टू गो होई सगुन एंड एवरी साइड नाउ ऑल गुरु मींस गुरु मींस रियली अ ट्रू थिंग इट मींस व्हेन इट देयर अ होल बिग साइंस अबाउट दिस इन द वर्ल्ड व्हेन एन इवेंट हैपेंस that can be classified as either a good omen or a bad a good, in Trinidad we say a good sign. Good sign or a bad sign. It is, there's a whole science. Don't start, what you call, making things a good sign and bad sign without studying the science. Because there are some people say, no, that's a good sign, that's a bad, that's a, like that. You don't know until you study it as a big science in Ayodhya Kanda, you will see there, when they were going, when Bharat was going to meet Ram, Guha and all his people thought, what? He's going with an army, he's going to kill Ram. We'll finish him before he reaches there. Like that. That time, from the left side of a crowd, a man sneezed. And they said, that's a good sign. But they go, no fight. Yeah? But it's a whole big sign. So here now, he says, when they started decorating their cars, wedding is set, date is put, lagan, everything all put in place. Now, and they started decorating to form this barat. Now, good signs everywhere. You see, nice things happening like that. And Tulsidasji describes Lord Shiva's dress now. All the ganas. Ganas means Lord Shiva's attendants, so those who come there and there with him. And he doesn't have regular attendants, you know. Lord Shiva is called, I told you in the past, he called us Ashutosh. And he is the one who is the refuge for all those who have no refuge. So now look here. In this world is made up of all types of beings and people and creatures and all sorts of things, right? So his ganas are made up of all those who are rejected by the world. These are those people who are rejected by the world. And this world is quick to reject people, you know. See, look here. Sometimes rejecting people, helping people is what we are supposed to do. We reject them. Isn't it? Because there is a place and time for everything and you have to be prudent and you have to think about your actions and all that kind of thing. Like a drunk man gone in front of the church. Drunk fella. People coming out from the church. That is the house of God, you know. He asked them, hey, give me $5 to buy a sandwich now. So the man will come out from the church, hey, Hato, get lost from here. What is the matter with you? In front of the church, you're coming with inauspicious act so soon in the morning. We now not come out from church. They chase him out. So he walking down the road and he had a rum shop. He walked down the road to a rum shop. A drunk man coming out from the rum shop. He said, well, yeah, give me $5 to buy a sandwich now. The drunk man say, what $5? Take $10 and buy two. Drunk man give him $10. This beggar say, are wa, Bhagwan? But yeah, Jeep Bata, you live in one place and you walk in the next place. When I go on where you live in, me again? That means you walk in from here? But see, it's society is quick to reject this one and reject that one and reject, isn't it? Quick to reject. But anybody who is rejected in this world, if anybody feel rejected, anybody feel neglected, lost and forlorn and overlooked and pushed to the fringes of existence and anything, anybody feels any of these things, the best Lord to worship is Lord Shiva. He is the one who will accept unconditionally. And now his ganas were there. Now they start to dress he up for this wedding. Well, you know, you have people who dress up the bride, people who dress up the groom, people who be there to do all them things, right? They start to dress he up for this wedding now. See this now, Lord. But Tulsidas, he described this thing very nicely today. Siva Sambu Ganakara hi Singara. They start to decorate he. Eh? Singara means they decorate, start to decorate he now. Who he own ganas? And what kind of ganas he have? Just now that will be described also just now. Jata Mukut Ahi Mauru Sawara. You know the bride, the groom does always wear a crown. Well, they make he crown a snake. He crown and he had make a snake now stand up so. They must train them snake, you all stand up right, they don't move, eh? They tell them snake and I'm like, so he crown made out a snake. Then Kundala Kankana Pahire Biala. His earring, any bangle, any anklet, everything make out a snake. Everywhere he wearing snake. Tana vibhuti pata ke hari chala on his body. He have this ashes they get from the cremation site, you know, from where they burn dead people. He bring home a bucket anytime he go. He whole body covered with that ashes now. And he went, they say, but you have to wear some clothes. Because he don't wear clothes. One of the names of Lord Shiva is called Digambara. Yes, one of his names is Digambara. Digambara means the space is he clothes. That means you wear no clothes. So they tell him, well, you have to wear some clothes now because, you know, we're going to some other people's place. How are you going to look? You have to wear some clothes. So they go and they get a lion skin now. This line says, let me see the line. Tana vibhuti pata ke hari chala. The skin of a lion. Ke hari a lion. Sasilata sundara giri sira ganga. And on his forehead now he has moon. On his head he has ganga. All of these things. So they get things and they dress you up with all of these things. And now, in his hand, he holding Trishul. Huh? His throat blue. And around his neck, they put on a mala for he made out a skull. You know, gold and thing, you know. He mala make out a skull, the dead people's head. 24 carat? No, 24 carat, yeah. 24 skull. Garalakanta ura narasela mala. Asiva besha. Sivadhama Kripala. And so Tulsidas's description, the poetry of Tulsidas is phenomenal. Eh? Those people who are interested in poetry and all, you see, you have really never read anything until you have read the poetry of Tulsidas. It is amazing. But to enjoy that, you have to read in that language, isn't it? Look here. If these type of writings. There was a great, great person in the last century, in the beginning of the last century. His name was Rabindranath Tagore. Have you heard that name? Rabindranath Tagore wrote a little skinny book. That book, thin like this. He wrote that in Bengali. The book was called Gitanjali. Gitanjali, it wasn't fatter than this. He wrote it in Bengali. And after writing it in Bengali, Tagore translated that Bengali work into English. But I don't know Bengali. So back in the 80s, I read that English translation. If you want to be moved by poetry, if you ever want to be moved by poetry, you have to read that Gitanjali. And do you know, this poet was such a great soul that he submitted a translation of an original Bengali work, and with a translation, he won the Nobel Prize in Literature. Can you imagine the original? A translation could never do justice to an original work. And with the translation, he won the Nobel Prize in 1913. Imagine if, when I read that, I said, man, if I wanted to go and learn Bengali just to read that thing, to learn a whole new language just to read that. But I had a choice between Bengali and Sanskrit. If I learn Bengali, I had to enjoy only. Because Bengali, what do you go teach in Bengali? If I learn Sanskrit, I could share the scriptures with people. That was the choice. But the poetry of these poets, and that's in the original language, that will move you to your bone, man. So these words of Tulsidasji, his composition is just super. And English could never catch the ras. Ras means the essence. Asiva besha, siva thama kripala. In, now see, they put on snake for he, ashes and all these things from skull and all kind of thing. In the myth, Tulsidasji says, and this is the line. I try to catch that in English. In the midst of all of this inauspicious outer garb laid, submerged, the ocean of compassion. In the midst of this external outer garb. And do you know? In the midst of this jagat, this sansar in which we are living, in the midst of this universe, which may be characterized by dwandva, positive and negative and good and bad, in the midst of this, the Lord exists everywhere, but we don't see. So Lord Shiva was submerged in the midst of this inauspicious wave. But the most auspicious Lord himself was submerged right there in the midst. But the words of Tulsidasji, now in English I am just explaining to you, but the words of Tulsidasji are super. So, Garalakan, then that poison in his throat, Kara Trishul, he holding that Trishul in his hand now. Aru Damaru Baja. And the next hand, Biraja, Damaru Yolin. That Damaru, you know? That little drum. Chale Basaha Chari Bajahi Baja. And now we climb up on a bull. Then Nandi Baba. Now you know when Dulha going all day again, nice wearing car, and they get the best car in the village. In the old days, they get the best horse in the village and they decorate a horse and he gone up on a bull now. And bull are not known for people riding on their back. Bulls, people don't like nobody to ride on their back. If a bison is okay. Eh? We know. Yeah, we know well. I used to deal with Mona and all of them riding bison all in the back here. You never see anybody riding any bull. He climb up on a bull now. You don't know what will happen. And they're going now. This is Bharat going now. Lord Shiva, Vishnu, Lord Vishnu, Brahmaji, all the gods, everybody, they're going in this Bharat. Then, Tulsidasji does the description. You jump down just before the Chanda. he gives a Tulsi Raji gives a description of that Bharat no. Oh. Brahmaji tell, Lord Vishnu tell, look, everybody go in their own group. Everybody go in their own group. And Lord Vishnu and Brahmaji, them gone in front. Them go in front of the Dulha also. Right? Because the Dulha Bharat, so inauspicious. The Dulha Bharat who following he, if them feel, if they stay with he, them go look bad too, you know, so them gone in front. Yeah. So now, the Bharat following Lord Shiva in the back now, that Bharat is being described. See, Tulsi Raji, right.
मुख ही न विफुल मुख काहु
Tulsidas takes, Tulsidas must be find it very amusing also. Tulsidas takes several dohas and chopais to describe this Bharat. Eh? List how the Bharat was ko mukhahin. Some of the people following that Bharat didn't have no mouth. Ko mukhahin, bipula mukha kahu. Some of them had too many mouths. Then, Binupada Karako, some of them have no feet and no hands. And some of them had too many feet and hands. Ko Bahupada Bahu. Bipula Nayana Ko, Nayana Bihina. Some had no eyes. And some had too many eyes. They have eyes all behind their head and all about. Rishta Pushta Ko Ati Tanakhina. Means to say, some of them were overweight, and some of them underweight, skin and bone. This is the kind of Bharat following. Tanakhina ko atipina pawana ko apawana gati dhare. Some of them with these thin, skinny bodies looking like skeleton. Skeleton following. And looking inauspicious. Bhushana karala kapal, holding skulls in their hands and wearing skulls on their necks and all that kind of thing. Karasavasadya jon and paste their body with fresh blood. Karaswana swara sikala mukha gana besha aganita kogane. And he said the numbers of them were so much nobody can count. Some of them have dog head, Some of them have donkey head. Some of them have pig head. Some of them have a jackal head. Different type of head on human body and all kind of thing. And so I see the next line. Bahu jenasa preta pisacha jogi jamata baranata nahibane. And so many ghosts and goblins and witches and lagahu and lajables and all kind of thing fall. Following that barat. But you think this funny? Wait till they reach by the Dulahin house, they know. Oh, Rama. When they reach there, all the children, when they see this barat, them children start to ball and run home, run all about and hide in all under the bed and thing. This barat, what that barat or that Yamraj coming there? They think Lord of Death, everybody run away and hide and thing. Only the older people and all who couldn't run, them stand up. That's the description, just like that only, exactly what I'm telling you. They couldn't run away, they could do now. Yeah, yes. So this barat come the most, no. That news reach Maina. Maina is the mother of Parvati. Now see what a thing. She here. Because remember, this whole wedding fix in the old days, they used to fix wedding, bride and groom as see each other and thing, isn't it? That's why they used to raise that thing, that veil from the daddy person you went to marry? Yeah. Close the back. They used to have to do a identification there. Isn't it? They have to do identification. That's part of the wedding and all. One fellow went in the bank and withdraw some money. The bank tells him, well, you can't withdraw money like that. You have to identify yourself. He take out a mirror. He said, yeah, it's me. Identify himself. So now, when Maina heard this news, Maina didn't see it. She only heard the news. Of what kind of? Maina's exclamation, you know. Look at you. You are such a most beautiful princess. The Lord himself made you. And now you, that Lord make that type of husband become that type of barat for you? Barat for you? What does Lord do? Maina, when she's saying modern language, Maina totally lost it. Quickly, Himavan, he has to get Narad. He get Narad first. And, oh great Rishi, please do something. Narad and the king and all the Rishis now who were gathered to do the ceremony, they all went to Maina's quarters. And Narad had to explain to Maina, don't mind all this thing. That husband who Parvati is going to marry, that husband is Jagadishwara. And Parvati is Jagadambika. The mother of the universe. It's not any ordinary marriage. And you please don't be upset. Everything will turn out fine. Narad explain over and over to Maina. And then Maina calmed down because Maina makes many types of comments inside of there about it appears, this is her comment, it appears as though woman's life is only to suffer. That type of commenting. So, all of the things that you hear generally in society and all that also, is that is there inside the Ramayana also. Maina's commented like that because it means women are subjected in all societies at all times. Women are subjected, and don't talk about modern society and thing. We say women have freedom and this and that, women are subjected to all sorts. They always get the losing end of the wrong end of the stick. Correct or not? No matter what all modern society you talk about today, even today in the most advanced countries, women do the same work and get less pay. Correct or not? They may do more work. So it's a fact. Ramayana stated all these things for every society at all times. It appears that women born to suffer. We're doing more work and getting less pay. And you see the households where women work and all, they go and they work in that job. Husband goes and work in his job. And when they come home, the wife still does all the housework and the husband does. He sleep. Yeah. You see? So Maynard's word is correct actually. So anyway, like I told you, everything there is so much I can't go into. All right. No, all the rishis gathered there now. Bring this Lord, you know, Maynard said, okay. All the rishis gathered and now all the ceremony is to take place. Now. This will be now number 100.
सासन गणपति ही पूजे शंभु भवानी राम पूजे शंभु भवानी ओ सुनी संशय कर जनी सुर नाथिय जान सिया पर राम चंद्र जी जय राम पवन सुत हनुमान
one of the most amazing Doha in this Balkan. What is that? See now, please pay attention to this. Eh? Who is getting married to who? Lord Shiva is getting married to Parvati. Right? Lord Shiva is getting married to Parvati. The rishis say, oh, now to all the sidong. You know the sidong by the mandap there? To all the sidong. Now first we're going and do Ganapati Puja. Ganesh is their son. He is born yet. Isn't it? But they're going to do Ganapati Puja first. Because every auspicious undertaking starts with Ganesh Puja. Ganapati Puja. But what happened was, Tulsi Raji said, immediately people go feel, but this was something wrong there. How, he ain't even born yet. He ain't come into the world yet. And they're going to do Ganesh Puja. But the sophistication of Hinduism is superbly amazing. It has so many things have to be understood. There are cycles. Cycles of Satyug, Tretayug, Dwaparyug, and Kalyug. And then it goes around because this world is cyclical. Everything in the world is cyclical. What goes around? Comes around. And in the next Kalpa, when it comes again, Satyug, Tretayug, Dwaparyug. And then in that Tretayug, Ganesh is born. But Ganesh's name is so powerful, Ganesh's name is so well known, that by the time the next yug comes around, his name is not gone. Some people name persist now. You know that? In the world, some people name persist. Look nowadays, how many union leaders they have? So many union leaders they have. But the moment you talk about union leader, George Weeks come to mind. Correct or not? Or Butler. Those names. But it has so many names. But you will remember? Some names persist. Lord Ganesh is such a great being that his influence and his worship goes around in next Kalpa, even though he's not born yet, people are already worshipping him like that. So, Tulsidasi said that you should not have any doubt in your mind that this thing is possible, that the lords are eternal, the gods are eternal. They don't die, their name remains, they remain everything. In every yuga, even though he's not taken manifestation yet, he's there. And the line said, now it continues. Jasi bibahake bidhi shruti gai mahamunina so sabakarvai. Means just exactly as the Vedas tell, this wedding is supposed to be like this. And I was telling earlier the younger people, it is good to bear it true. All the things are symbolic and they are very good for developing a lot of great qualities to go through all of the rites. And here, Lord Shiva himself went through all of those rites. Step by step, the rishis, all the great rishis, Brahmaji as a witness, Lord Vishnu as witness, all the devatas as witness, all the saints and sages there now, chanted all the Vedic mantras, Gai Giri Sakusa Kanya Pani Bhavahi Samarpi Jani Bhavani. And the father of Parvati, Himavan, he himself brought her hand and gave to Lord Shiva, called Pani Grahan. Pani Grahan. Weddings take different forms. In the old days, they have different forms and all. The wedding which we know today was finalized by the Indian government in 1956 only. This Saptapadi, Agni Sakshi, going around the fire seven times, that was finalized by the Indian government when they were trying to codify Hindu law in 1956. Otherwise, prior to that, there are countless types of wedding. 1956 is recently. Countless type of wedding. So Pani Grahan is called. Once the father puts the hand of the daughter in the hand of Lord Shiva, and they put a piece of kush grass there. That time, mantras are chanted and all that. That was the form of the wedding. And there was a form in Punjab. The groom comes on a horse. He rides on a horse and he has a sword on the side. The bride comes out from that house and she walks. He's up by the gap in front there. The bride comes out from the house. Everybody and on the bride's side. And they go there and they touch this. She touch the sword we have on the side. He come down from the horse yet, you know. She touched the sword. Wedding done. Yeah, that time he pulls you up on the horse and gone. All this type of wedding, the Indian government was faced with all of these various types of weddings. So they brought it under one codified marriage. With just go around the fire seven times, seven steps and all. That was the crux of the whole thing. But that was the most common thing in whole of India at the time. But though you had so many thousands of different forms of marriage. Here now, they all chanted the mantras and the father gave the hand of Giri Sakusakanya Pani Bhavahi Samarpi. Samarpi means he gave the hand. Jani Bhavani, knowing her to be the mother of the universe herself. Gahi Giri Pani Grahana Jabakina, when Lord Shiva held her hand. Pani Grahana Jabakina Mahesa. Here, Harashe, Tavasakala Suresa, all the gods and Brahmaji and everybody, Beda Mantra Muni Bara Uchadahi, they were happy and the rishis chanted all the mantras loudly. The marriage was Jai 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 Shankar Sura Karahi. The marriage of Bhagwan Shiva and Parvati is pronounced by all the gods saying Jai Jai Jai, all of them. Jai 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 Kar rented the air everywhere in this great marriage. Now the gods were very happy. Gods are selfish fellows, eh? They're happy for one reason. They're not happy for Shiva. They're happy because now they will have a son who will kill Tarkasur. Throw this Rama in there like that, eh? They don't care who die, who live. Once we happy, yes. They're happy because Lord Shiva will have a son who will kill Tarkasur and we will be saved. You will see this Rama in. They're like that. So this world will have selfless people and the world will have selfish people. Lord Shiva, Parvati, selfless. All the gods? Selfish. They only think about themselves only. Anyway, this is the marriage of this Shiva and Parvati. And this is the coming together of Shraddha, Vishwas. Means, I told you, when this happens only, then the wedding of Rama and Sita can. This is the development of great faith in the heart of the being. When faith comes in the heart of the being, that being can merge with Ishwara. So that Sita can marry Ram. Sita is Jiva, Ram is Ishwara. So this happens first in Ramayana. Then Tulsidas Ji will repeat that wedding will come long after Rama's wedding. Shiva Parvati Vivaha. But now, just to conclude there, Parvati, in order to reach this state, and this is a symbolic thing, Parvati, in order to reach this state, had to go through lifetime of purification, lifetime of rehabilitation, lifetime of the removal of certain traits from the personality and the inclusion of other traits. And all jivas, all of us have to go through lifetimes. Bhagavan Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam janmanamante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabha. Rare is that one person who purifies his life over a great long many lifetimes and merges with me. So all our journey is the same journey. It will not take 1 year or 2 years. See, Bhagavan meditated for 87,000 years. That time Parvati sitting there. How long it takes and how much tapas and how. So the journey is a long one. The journey requires a lot of austerities, tapas, a lot of things like that. But everyone is charged with that responsibility of treading that path. And eventually merging with God. That is all other symbolism with that. Jiva merge with God. Alright. Now, 9 days is a very short thing. We're doing this Ramayana for a year and a half now. Really? More than a year and a half. Almost 2 years. In 2 months, we're going to make 2 years. 1 year, 10 months. We still have finished. So, in 9 days, I think we have covered quite a bit. I hope that you have gotten something to make your life also better from the stories which are there in the Ramayana. All right. Couple quick things. Every year, we have the Varsha Pratipada Sansad